Hello, I, Lillykutty Abraham, from the Department of English, Kristu Jayanti College, Bengaluru, present a novel titled Chemmeen, written by Thakazhi Sivasankara Pillai. The presentation focuses on information about the author, about the novel, the plot of the novel, the structure of the novel, and the main themes discussed in the novel, and finally a special reference to the sea as mother. The first subtopic, the author, Thakazhi Sivasankara Pillai. Thakazhi was born in the year 1912 in a place called Kuttanada in Alappuzha district of Kerala, India. He is a novelist and short story writer of Malayalam literature. He has over 30 novels and novellas, and he has written more than 600 short stories, and most of his works focus on the lives of the oppressed. He is known for his works such as Kayar, which was written in 1978, and Chemmeen, which was written in 1956. He was awarded Jnanpith in the year 1984 for the novel Kayar, and he was conferred Padma Bhushan in the year 1985. He breathed his last in the year 1999. As most of his works focused on the lives of the oppressed and the downtrodden, he has this to say about Chemmeen. I quote, "All that I have described in Chemmeen are things I have seen and known. I had in fact merged with the lives of those fisherfolk. Living on the seashore, there are many things special about their customs, unlike ours." Unquote. So when we read Chemmeen, we get to know that this is what he has depicted in the novel Chemmeen. Now, the novel Chemmeen, the term Chemmeen in Malayalam, which means, or which can be translated into English as prawns or shrimp. Chemmeen, the novel, was translated into 19 world languages and adapted into film in 15 countries. It won the Kendra Sahitya Academy Award, India's second highest literary prize, in the year 1957. Chemmeen was the first significant Malayalam novel to be translated into English after India gained independence. It was accepted as part of the UNESCO collection of representative works for the Indian series. The film adaptation with the same name, Chemmeen, in Malayalam, directed by Ramu Kariyat, won the National Film Award for Best Feature Film in the year 1965. Now, the plot of the novel. Chemmeen Kunjan, a fisherman in Nirkunathu, has only one ambition in his life, that is to own a boat and a net. Being a fisherman who has to be content with what the mother sea offers on a daily basis, he is not able to save the required amount to buy the boat and the net. His grown-up daughter Karathamma mediates with her childhood playmate Parikutti, who is a trader in fish in the same seashore, for his financial assistance so that Chemmeen Kunjan, her father, can buy the boat. Owing to his love for Karathamma, Parikutti willingly helps Chemmeen Kunjan on a condition that the fish hauled in the new boat must be sold to Parikutti. Having owned the much desired boat and net, Chemmeen Kunjan becomes greedy, and not only he breaks the promise but also insults Parikutti when he approaches to claim his share of fish. Chemmeen Kunjan prospers while Parikutti becomes bankrupt. Meanwhile, both Parikutti, a Muslim youth, and Karathamma, a Hindu fisherwoman, have fallen in love against the custom of the seashore. Their love for each other becomes known, and Karathamma is often reminded of her duty as a fisherwoman to be chaste for the well-being of her future husband. Chemmeen Kunjan gets Karathamma married off to an orphan named Palani from Trichinopoly. During the wedding ceremony, Chakki, Karathamma's mother, becomes invalid owing to the scandals about Karathamma. Chembankunji disowns his daughter and his decline begins. After the death of Chakki, he marries Papikunji, but she fails to replace Chakki. In Trikkannapuzha, Karathamma and Palani put up with all the insults on account of her relationship with Parikuthi. Palani is ostracized by his community, yet he trusts Karathamma and both of them together build up a family. Karathamma is not able to forget Parikuthi yet. One night, when Palani is battling with a huge shark in the deep sea, Karathamma and Parikuthi meet and their love is rekindled. Palani is caught in a large whirlpool and swallowed up by the waves. After 2 days, the dead bodies of both Karathamma and Parikuthi, locked in an embrace, came to rest on the sands. A dead shark, with a lion still attached, was also found on the seashore. And now, let's look at the structure of the novel, Chemmeen. The novel is divided into two parts. Part 1 is set in the seashore of Nerkunnappu, and this part deals with Karathamma's life before her wedding with Palani, and here she falls in love with Parikuthi. And simultaneously, we have also the description of Chembankunji, her father, prospering, having horns on the body and the necks. In part 2, in contrast, it is set in Trikkannapuzha. Here, Karathamma's life after her wedding with Palani is depicted, and side by side, we can see the decline of Chembankunji. Now, the major themes of the novel Chemmeen is first and foremost the myth of chastity. A fisherwoman is expected to remain chaste for the safety and well-being of her fisherman, her husband, who would be battling in the deep sea, in the unknown areas of sea, and it is dangerous for him. Only if she remains chaste, he can come back. So the sea lore of the first fisherman is delineated in the beginning of the novel itself. The first fisherman was able to return only because his wife remained virtuous, remained chaste, so he was not swallowed up by the shark. And I quote, "In this vast sea there is much to fear, all of which determines whether a man who goes out to the sea will return. And the only thing we can do as women is keep them safe with true minds and bodies. Otherwise, they and their bodies will be swallowed up by the undertow. The life of the man who goes out to sea rests in the hands of his woman on the shore." In addition, a fisherman's well is his fisherwoman's virtue. So this is instilled in the minds of the fisher women. As she grows up, she is educated with this vision or with this theme or with this idea in her mind that she needs to be pure. She needs to be pure in her mind and body. And on the contrary, towards the end of the novel, we find that Karathamma, since she could not remain loyal and faithful and chaste, Palani meets out his fate being swallowed by the waves. The savior deity of the fisherman at sea is her fisherwife at home. He is asking her to perform tapasya like the ancient fisherwife. Tapasya is single-minded attention towards something, and that single-minded devotion and attention is expected of a fisherwife at home while her husband is struggling to earn their living in the deep sea. Since Karathamma couldn't be loyal, couldn't be chaste, Palani is caught in the cross current and the boat stood erect like a pillar and then sank. He doesn't return. And this is the fate. Had she remained chaste, had she remained loyal, Palani could have come right. But Palani doesn't come right. So the myth of chastity is proved in this novel. Now the next major theme is tradition versus modernity. We have two sets of people, one who would advocate traditionalism, the other would advocate modernity. People like Achakunya, Raman Mopan, Nallapanna, Palani are who advocate tradition, the values of tradition, the values of care and caring and sharing. They are for the social well-being of the community. Here on the other hand, we have people like Chembanpunya's family and Parikutti who would look for their individual benefits of the modernism, the themes or the ideas of modernism creeping into their minds. So they would not think of the well-being of the community. So the question that again and again is asked in the novel is, why does a fisherman have to hoard anything? It's the mother sea who is supposed to take care of us, and we just go by her seasons, her times, we just respect her. But on the other hand, we find Chembanpunya struggling to buy boards and nets, and he buys boards and nets, and he's unconcerned whether his daughter is of marriageable age or not. And he forgoes the dictates of the seashore, the ethics of the seashore, that a grown-up girl has to be married off. He is unconcerned about that. Paru tells Karuthamma about their life, that they are not supposed to hoard anything. When the sea is fertile, when she offers in abundance, they live life accordingly in plenty. And when the sea is off season, when the sea is barren, they live accordingly. It must be endured. An ordinary fisherman's vision of life is that when the sea is barren, you respect that. When the sea is fertile, enjoy the bounty of the sea. But Karuthamma, who has learned greed, she wants to earn and hoard things just like her father. The barren state of the sea must be endured. That is what the traditional idea is. You respect the resources of the earth. Use it sustainably. But here, a bunch of people, they want to save, and they want to save it only for themselves, not even caring and sharing about the others. So this tension between tradition and modernism. Okay. And we come to the second part again, the Chemmeen advocating traditionalism. We find that the novel proves that Palani, the mythical figure, is caught in the undercurrent due to Karuthamma's betrayal. If she had remained faithful, if she had remained chaste, Palani would have returned. And he never returns to the shore. And it is the story just contrary to the first fisherman. So Chemmeen advocates the traditional values of remain chaste, remain pure in body and mind, with single-minded attention towards her husband. Now, the other sub-themes or the areas that we can focus on traditionalism is Chembanpunya's transgression of buying board and net, which he is not supposed to. A fisherman is not supposed to buy board and net. That is not his job as the category as fisherman. But he does it. He doesn't marry of his grown-up daughter. He breaches the rules of the seashore, that the small fish, the fry, is to be left free so that the poor and the destitute can collect it. He, Chembanpunya, in his greed, even sells off those little fish as well. So, as a result, he faces the decline in his life. He who was soaring high in his pride has the same, he falls in the same sea which was the cause of his flourish, and now he falls in the sea. His leg becomes weak. His leg is Chakki. Symbolically, it is Chakki, his wife, who supported him. She dies. and after that he is a shattered man. Even after having a lot of pleasure, even after having a lot of money and wealth, he is not able to enjoy pleasure. After the loss of his wife, he marries Papikun, yet Papikun couldn't entice him. He becomes a devastated, insane human being who is not able to even function properly. Even after having everything he wanted, he is not able to live a life of happiness. So, Chemmeen advocates traditionalism. Remain or follow the values of sharing, caring, and taking care of the resources. And a special reference to see as mother in this novel is also attempted in this presentation. The see plays an active role in the novel. See is just like an active character. So you will find the emotional involvement of the sea. At times, the sea is represented as angry. The sea would be sad and sea would be happy. The sea can even smile on happy occasions. The fertility and barrenness of the sea is mentioned often in the sea. Just like a woman, she too has the menstruation. She is a woman, a goddess who would bless everyone in the seashore. She is a caring mother to everyone, and especially to Palani, who is an orphan. And finally, it is the sea who receives Palani into herself, and Palani doesn't return. And finally, to conclude, Chemmeen, the tragic love story of Karathamma and Lillykutty, ends with a few questions that echo in the minds of the readers. For whom did Chemmeen earn the wealth that he much desired for? Why was he not able to enjoy the fruit of his hard labor? Why didn't the parents of Karathamma restrict her in her childhood when she began to play with those who were not children of the sea? And these questions remain in our mind when the novel concludes with a picture of two young innocent orphan girls, Anjumi and Karathamma's daughter, wandering on the seashore. And our hearts are left with gloomy feelings and unanswered questions. And that is the impact of Chemmeen, this love story. Thank you.